out.
So I pull one of any color that I have, right? Like the one of these cards. Right.
Which
I feel like piloting is probably
really goddamn multi-talented because you can pull him anything he wants pretty much.
Except engineering.
Except engineering, yes.
Okay, I'm gonna link. Okay. And then I am gonna move out of sick bay to back to command. Yeah. And then I can use my once per turn. Oh no. Wait. Yeah, so I can activate two Vipers, and my once per turn is go into the Viper. Yeah? Okay. Is all of this making sense so far? I'm not doing something stupid.
Yeah. No, that's making total sense.
So one back here and one...
You can activate them both in the same place if you want.
Yeah, because you have for launch bait, right?
No, you can put them both on the same side if you wanted to.
Oh.
Is there any reason to do this, though?
If you wanted more attacks on the Heavy Raider when it comes up.
Well, not to spoil the plot, but I have another maximum firepower.
Okay.
So that's been my plan this whole time, is to just defend against the Heavy Raider with me, and then try and get this guy back to defend. That's been what I've been trying to do.
Also remember that we're at the end of our jump prep, so any crisis that has plus one, we just leave all this behind.
That's a good point. Indeed. This shit needs to get gone. Okay, well, I think... Say it again?
We're better off covering off the Heavy Raider as much as possible.
Right, so if my crisis is Heavy Raider activate... It's actually.
I think these should be here.
Okay. Okay. So that's fine. You guys are the experts.
If we need to, we can shoot it.
I'm just fucking winging it. Okay, so that's my moves, actions, draws. It is now crisis.
Don't fuck it up. A traitor accused. Wow.
So we at the end of this we jump.
Wait a minute, one second now, did the Raiders move first so they get a shot at the Viper or?
No. Well, I don't know, I'm not sure.
Yeah, so at the end of this
activation happens before the jump prep.
So they get the shot at trying to destroy Pelukan. Should they succeed or fail? Then we're off.
Right. So he either gets recovered or he goes to sick bay at the end of this turn. I only have three cards, so the ore here seems not that bad,
like a good
to be honest.
Shut up, Styla.
So,
it is a good choice.
I mean, one of them's a really good card, the other two are shit. I don't. But...
There's no reason that you can't just choose Max to go to the...
Say that again?
We pick this...
On the fail?
We fail it, and you just send him to the brig, because he's already there.
But I'm already at the brig, that makes sense?
Is that... Can you brig somebody that's in the brig? Let's Google it.
I don't see why not.
It doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense, that's true.
Can you send a player who's already in the brig to the brig? That's the question.
Yeah.
The specific case of characters in the brig is covered in the back.
Is the back in this thing?
It's over here on the left.
Never mind, guess not.
Yeah, it says If the player is required to choose a character to send to the brig or sickbay, can he choose a character that is already there? Answer, no. He also cannot choose a revealed Cylon player before he is on...
Before he is on the board.
Okay, so...
So no, you cannot send me...
Failing this would not... unless we want to put somebody else in the brig. So failing this is not great. We're going to use more than three cards to check this, I would imagine. I can sort of help this a little bit, but I'm leaning to the ore here. Let's get the fuck out of here, get all these shits off the board and reset.
But you don't have to play a character.
Right. I assume it's just means I have to discard the three and we're done.
But you said fight.
Yeah, let's Google that now. BSG, TTS.
Well, TTS doesn't matter. This is
board game. Discard requirements. Discard skill cards when you have none. Question, there's often the option to discard skill cards on a crisis card. Can you choose the option if there are not enough cards to discard? For example, President chooses -1 food, or President discards 2 skill cards and the current player discards 3. And the President's choice... random guy Dave D says this is permissible unless the crisis card specifically says you cannot.
Yeah, this is permissible unless the crisis card specifically says you can't, apparently.
Okay, so that's still what I'm leaning towards.
When a player makes a choice on a crisis card, you can always choose the top or bottom section, regardless of it, whether or not they'll be able to fulfill the game text.
Okay.
Well, I think they should discard the card, because like losing this one is actually pretty bad.
It also says in the rules, choice crisis, when a player makes a choice on a crisis card, he can always choose the top or bottom section of the card, regardless of whether he will be
able to fill
the game.
Okay, I will discard my three cards.
Good.
These go face up, right, in the discard?
Yeah.
Okay, so the Raiders get a shot at Kalimana.
Yeah,
they do.
So each raider gets a roll, 5 to 7 damaged, 8 destroyed. Do I roll since it's my turn?
Yes. Don't fuck it up. Obligatory. 6.
So that's 1 damage. Oh, he's Bell's damage.
86. Evasive maneuvers.
Okay. Play after the Viper is attacked, re-roll the die. And if the Viper is piloted, subtract 2 from the new roll. Okay.
Okay, so... There you go.
0.
I rolled a 0.
Wait,
okay, so now I do the second attack. Five. No effect.
You're damaged again. Unless
is it?
Have a card again for that.
No, I don't.
Off to sickbay, Pell goes.
Off to sickbay, and you're damaged.
Oops, that's not what I need. Okay. And then we advance. We advance the fleet prep and GTFO. Yeah? Is that correct?
Correct.
Yeah.
Go back to start. We clear the board. Dark pulls a destination card. Pulls 2 and...
Fuck it up, Dark.
I don't think he will. The first one was pretty good.
Yeah, this wasn't bad at all.
A lot of them are really garbage.
Yeah, I remember being really kind of like disappointed with the destinations. So I wouldn't be surprised if we end up fucked here somehow. Icy Moon. Lose one fuel. The Admiral may risk one raptor to roll a die. If three or higher, gain one food. Otherwise, destroy the raptor. Do you want to...
You're doing fine.
Wait. Did you put the other one on top, Dark?
No, I put it in the bottom.
Okay. You have to put
I thought you dragged the... Well, it doesn't matter, I guess. Whatever.
I moved the whole deck off to the side. So.
Right, and then somebody...
Right. One on the bottom, and then...
Right, but then somebody dragged that from here to the top of the pile of those over here and moved the whole pile over here.
Well,
I probably agree not.
How about we just burn the top one? It doesn't matter.
I'm not willing to risk a raptor for one exit.
But you have to do that.
Okay.
It's not May. It says May, yeah.
Yeah.
Admiral decides, okay. Seriously.
So it is now Max's turn, yeah.
Finally. Well, I cannot move out of there, but I'm gonna repair your
fridge. You get the
Vipers. Get to fix two of those.
Can't. You have to be
in the hangar bay.
Ah, yeah, I have to be in the hangar bay. Well, that's a shame.
Rip.
Then I'm gonna make someone repair them for me. I'm gonna choose two cards from Lucan, who's the next player in the order, with my treatment action, which means I get to choose two cards at random for Lucan, and I get to choose two of his at random as well.
Well, you draw two from his skill set, not from his hand. So you pick any
green, purple, or red.
I can pick any green ones that I want. Yeah, I'm gonna pick two green ones.
Wait a minute. Also, and, like, it says random. That doesn't mean that you can just give him the repair ability.
It doesn't say random.
Random.
It doesn't say random.
I choose a human player and draw two skill cards from. Then I give him two skill cards from my hand.
Okay. You said random. So...
Yeah, I thought it was random. Sorry.
It's not.
I don't think we need to repair Vipers right now. We've got only one that, and that card.
No, there should be two.
No, we didn't put these back in the right place.
There are three damaged. So yeah, you probably want to repair stuff. There you go. Those two cards are yours. I really picked my two out of you. And I forgot to grab my own cards. I get one politics. I get two tactics. Engineering.
You're gonna have a lot more than 10 cards now, I think.
Cards. Yeah, I have too many cards. I'm gonna have to discard some stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Only one, right?
You have to discard down to 10. Yeah.
Okay, I have to discard two cards.
Yeah, each player must, at the end of your turn, though, so, or at the end of everything. So, once we do the. No, you're right. So that, I believe, is the end of your turn, so you have to discard. Does it say randomly?
No, it just says two cards. So I'm just
each player must discard down to 10 cards at the end of every player's turn.
Okay, I'm going to take my card.
Already done. Already discarded two. I'm down to 10.
Perfect. And I'm going to move to the hangar.
Hangar.
I looked up one of the questions we had earlier, so
what was
the when you reveal yourself as a Cylon player,
mm-hmm.
you discard down to three skill cards, you lose any titles you have, you resurrect by moving to the resurrection ship location, and you receive a super crisis card. One gets dealt to you at random.
Interesting.
Yeah, there's this whole playstyle that we haven't even like touched on.
Yeah.
Is there, so there is a chance right now that there are no Cylons, right? Like that is a possibility.
It is possible, yes.
I mean, it's unlikely, but possible. Like, in theory, that is...
It's not even that unlikely.
Isn't there some point where... Is it just destination cards that, like, you redraw loyalty cards or something? Sleeper agent phase. Oh, okay. There's a whole nother...
So once we get to four is when we...
That's what it was. Okay.
Gonna launch your shield on a Viper instead of repairing with one of the cards it gave you. Smart.
We still have a whole bunch that are, you know, not
Cylon. Yeah, we don't really have a. Well, you can launch and then play your action card. You can be in fucking space and then action is play the card, right?
No, he can't.
You can only take the action when you're in the hangar.
Oh, right. I'm used to me, because I'm fucking special.
Uh-huh.
Yes, indeed
you are. I'm kind of a big fucking deal, you guys. Kind of a big fucking deal. I am next in line to be the Admiral, just saying.
I will actually nuke whatever.
That'd be hilarious if you can nuke yourself. Like, fuck it. Going down with the ship.
Fine, I repaired the fucking Vipers. We get, you know, fucking ton of Raiders.
I wish we had more people in Vipers.
Well, there's 0% chance of getting Raiders right now, even on this crisis card. Oh. Wow.
Wow.
That's really unfortunate. Okay, so activate a Battlestar, and so
first thing that happens is we set up the board how it says.
Oh.
So we get two Vipers along with this,
dude. We get.
That's one too many Vipers. There you go.
They can go in the front. We need four up there.
Oh, I didn't read that. Sorry.
And you didn't want to prepare them. Fucking-tastic.
No, this is worse. I should have undocked. That would have been actually.
We would have only had one Viper spare at that point.
Yeah, because now.
Right now, I mean, this is bad, but. In theory, well, my turn's not for a while. Unless somebody executive orders me to get out there as well. Hey, Ronan. What's up, bud?
So, where are you right now?
Me? I am in the hangar bay.
So that your ability does not say during your turn. It just says when a Viper is placed into a space area from reserve.
Oh.
So you could be
up. Okay, so I'm...
You can be in one of those Vipers. Yeah.
That makes sense. Okay. So I will... Well, I don't really want to... Well, I guess I could take an action to move here so that this civilian ship doesn't die, right? Immediate. Well, this civilian ship won't die no matter what. Right? Because these have to go this way.
No. They don't have to go this way. They will go that way if it's equidistant. But since they're closer to this one, they will go to this one.
Yeah.
Oh, really? I thought... Oh... So I just completely misunderstood how these things worked then. I thought these had to go counterclockwise, or
they
clockwise rather.
Go to the nearest one, and if it's a tie, they go clockwise.
Okay. So it, for my action, it does make sense to move here so this does not die next.
Yes.
God, this is so fucking shit. We are zero on fleet plan, fleet prep, jump prep.
Whose turn it is?
This is Pell's, right?
This is current, and also it's a special rule, every unmanned Viper that attacks has -2 to its attack rolls, because fuck it, right? Literally.
I wish I was in a Viper now.
Jeez.
No, it's still better the way it is, because you can't...
Is there any way for Pell to get into a Viper that's deployed, or does he just launch and then put himself into a Viper? What is his actions? What are his actions? Star player, long shot. Once per game, you may choose the result of a die roll in your turn instead of rolling it. Okay, well, on my action, I can launch basically all of our Vipers to cover shit if we want to, as CAG. But not necessarily something... Yeah, it's a, I mean, you're not going to get any more fucked than we are right now. This is bad. This is for zero jump. This is about as bad as it fucking gets.
Palookan can destroy the base star with his Viper, and he's one in a turn. Yeah, you can, because you have a once in a game, choose your die result. So you move there, you destroy the base star because you choose an 8. And that's it. That's your only miracle. You can destroy the base star.
Oh yeah, I can go to weapons control and shoot it. I can...
Could.
Or you can also get in a Viper and do the same with your Viper.
Well, we won't
actually
know, cause...
that's not destroyed anyway. It's only damaged.
Oh yes, it's damaged.
But if I attack it with Galactica... Oh.
So we need a nuke, I think.
We're not using one nuke for one fucking base game.
It's one base there and a bunch of raiders.
Right.
There is collateral damage from using a nuke too.
How do nukes work?
It says in the admiral.
Action, launch one nuke at a base star. The nuke is removed from the game. On a roll of 1 to 2, damage the base star twice. 3 to 6, destroy the base star. 7 to 8, destroy the base star and 3 raiders.
You've been in the admiral quarters the whole fucking time.
No, he, yeah. Okay, well... Regardless, this has been resolved, yeah? The current crisis has been resolved, and it is now Gliss's...
No, we didn't do the roll. The activate was... Oh, that's after second. Never mind.
Oh, yeah. Activate... It's
so, activate was if there was a Battlestar out there already. So...
It's before the setup, right. So that doesn't... Yeah.
So there was none...
Right, so we are good. We are done, but at this point forward, right, then all unpiloted Vipers are minus 2 to attack rolls.
Until we jump, yes.
Jesus fuck. Remind me never to open my goddamn face again.
Man, that's fucked up. Okay.
This would have sucked if we would have got it.
This reminds you of Christmas with your three brothers trying to figure out the year's best board game? Yes. Except we have Pell, who everybody hates, and other than that,
that was incredibly Mike? Well played.
My turn then? Yes.
It's your turn, Gliss. Save us or something.
Yeah, so they do try.
And this is really bad because
would you use remain there a nuke in this case? Would you use a nuke in this case?
No, I think that we could launch some Vipers in the front of the ship and hit off these other raiders.
Okay.
And get Pell into a Viper and get him to defend.
Well, Pell's not going to get in a Viper until his turn, no matter what.
We have executive orders.
Yeah, you can executive order me. And I've got a couple cards that could really help killing some of those Vipers.
I think nuking is single base there because I want base there.
Are you maybe I'm just misreading the situation, but this seems catastrophic right here.
Yeah, but you're overreacting. Like the raiders still have to move around, so they'll need one turn to get to even one of our fucking supply ships. So
okay.
We do have the opportunity. I don't think we should nuke them. And nuking them to take out the raiders is going to take a 7 or 8 roll, which is quite.
Right, but there may be modifiers that Glissa or Pell or somebody would be willing to throw to the dice.
I can't do any fucking modifiers for combat.
What's that?
My lady is incapable of any modifiers for combat.
Right, but it's just a die roll modifier. Like, that anybody can have those.
No.
No?
President can't. There are no green cards that do that.
Okay. I don't understand how anything works, to be fair.
You need lighter purple ones for that. So, Pell, executive order on you.
Yes!
Oops, I put it in your hand. I'm sorry.
Back in, not my. I'm getting into a Viper right now.
You're doing whatever the fuck you want.
But I would suggest you get into a Viper.
I can. So, Siggy.
Yes.
I can launch.
Uh-huh.
Here's my idea.
I'm listening.
I can launch in this sector here.
Mm-hmm.
And then if they come in, I can try and fight them off. And when it's my activation, I've got the max couple maximum firepower cards that I can play and nuke either one.
Either direction.
It doesn't...
So having... Out of just to make sure I understand, if we are in this spot, right, and the Raiders advance here, the next time, even if we do nothing, they will attempt to destroy the Viper repeatedly until they destroy the Viper or damage it, and then they will roll against the civilian guard.
This is correct.
Yes.
So there are four chances to kill or damage the Viper that's here.
Correct.
I mean, one Viper here is kind of risking it a lot. I mean, I guess in the end...
If he launches and then he...
advances to be aggressive, right?
No, actually, he shouldn't because he can't attack yet. He should just let them move here and then respond.
And then try and be aggressive in that spot. Yeah.
So what, move back here? And then my turn...
Move forward and stay there.
Yeah.
And just... react to the Raiders when they get here.
Right. So here's the thing, though. It's Darks, and then Moppies, and then Max, and then me. So it's going to three turns at least.
Where there will be...
Almost executive orders. I mean, you have to remember, I have literally zero cards, so I don't... I mean, I'm completely useless right now, so don't executive order me. Well, I mean, that's not true. I can move and do something, I guess, if I needed to, if
I can do an executive orders, I can move into the this one up front.
Can you executive order yourself?
No. Somebody else would have to do
it. Right.
So I do have the maximum firepower. I'm assuming you don't have one.
I have nothing. I have literally zero cards.
Like, as much as I am impressed by your aggressiveness, I mean, you're still going to be moving forward into four fucking Raiders who then will have four chances to kill you if you roll badly.
Right. You want to stay put. You want them to roll in, so next time, assuming they activate, they'll come to you and they'll just sit there. And then you have an entire turn to react.
We also have to remember that we still have like 12 other supply ships, so like losing one might not be a complete disaster.
Well, unless it's... I mean, it could be like three population or something, and then... or. Well, you can't lose morale on civilian ships, I don't think.
Okay, so that's my activation. I'm done.
And lift up these crosses.
Oh my god.
What?
How the fuck?
You're pretty much fucked up.
I don't know how this works in conjunction.
First, you're gonna activate a bunch... No, yeah, because we already played one, now you're gonna play the other one. It says to activate the
Raiders. So the Raiders advance.
The Raiders are going to activate and move. And that's it. Because that's all they can do. They can either move or attack. And then the setup is going to place another base star.
I just did.
And
a heavy Raider fighters. In the back.
A heavy Raider in the back. Two more here. Another civilian ship here.
Jesus fuck.
Dark.
We're missing one more civilian ship here. There's another civilian ship that should be here. There we go. And wow, you really want
get them nukes out? Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna have to.
You can't jump.
Oh no! Special rule for heavy casualties: four Raiders that were just set up are immediately activated.
So at the front.
These four. Okay. Are missing four Raiders more.
Oh yeah, four additional Raiders. Jesus fuck!
You're literally super screwed, because these four raiders, now they can do something. They can.
Well, they can kill. No, they have to attack the Vipers. So we will be rolling damage against Vipers. So 5 to 7 damaged, 8 destroyed. Anything less than that, nothing happens. So.
Fan-fucking-tastic.
This is Glissa's roll, yeah?
Yeah.
So Glissa will be rolling.
Oh boy, okay.
I can't believe this is out here and we're on fucking zero jump rep.
Yeah, this is hilarious. These guys potentially...
Wait a minute. Why is he rolling?
Because, yeah, and the four... These four raiders that just got deployed, as a rule, now are activated. So 3, nothing happens. That's the first one. 5 to 7, that's a damaged Viper. Okay, and that's this one.
You still have 2 more attacks to do.
1, nothing happened. 2, nothing happened. Okay, that actually, that went about as well as we hoped. Jeez. I guess, like, worst case scenario, we just lose everything on the board, right? As we try to get the fuck out of here.
The crisis cards were shuffled before we started the game, right?
Yes.
Yeah. That is just catastrophically unlucky.
Yeah, that's that deserves a fucking screenshot, man.
Oh, this is going up on YouTube.
I want to see that.
So, Admiral.
Admiral.
If you don't want to be viewed as a Cylon, you better start fucking using those nukes.
Or else.
Or else.
I think Siggy and I can handle the Raider, but we're not going to handle the two base.
Please break me out of the brig. Let me
maybe
and start shooting the goddamn raiders everywhere.
Yeah, maybe
this guy over here, this Cylon wants out.
This guy.
At least now I have a compelling argument.
Dark Aronin's telling you to get those nukes out. Better get those fucking nukes out. No, but like this situation over here, there's like collateral damage. I don't, if I understand it right, there's no collateral damage to us, right? There's just you nuke the base star and
possibly
best case scenario, you damage the base. No, you kill the base star and damage kill 3 raiders.
Kill 3 raiders. That would be me. That would mean you will only have to fight
one
base star, 1 heavy raider, 1 raider over here, and fucking 8 raiders over here.
Right. This, I don't know what to do about this. I don't think nukes help that.
They can't. You can only target a base star.
Or I can at least move to the hangar deck, prepare 2, and then I can fucking start turning them out. Like 2 per turn.
Well, regardless. We can't get you out of the brig. You have to action.
Yeah, but you can help me out.
Well, sure, but I mean, that's 3 turns away from now. You've got 2 turns away from now.
Still, let's see if we survive that long again.
Unless, I mean, in theory, somebody could executive action you, and then could be...
They could executive action me out of there. That's true.
But I mean, I'm still in this situation. I can't do anything. Like I have no cards. I can't help anybody.
I could activate if you executive action myself out of the command. I can activate this Viper and start turning out stuff.
Yeah, but those Vipers are attacking with -2. So
right, unmanned Vipers are useless in my opinion right now. There's. I think we use these unmanned Vipers as checks.
I can go to weapons control.
That's our best bet.
I can start moving to weapons control and start churning out stuff at the base stars.
So we completed Gliss's turn. It's now Dark's turn. Dark is deciding what to do.
Dark, I say nuke.
I don't think nukes are going to help us.
I don't think you could possibly get worse of a situation than what we're in right now with at zero fleet jump prep and having a base star with raid. Like, I would use it here regardless for the chance of killing these raiders. This is gonna fuck us over here no matter what.
Tell you what, I have a card that can help you with the nuke roll.
He can play an assist card from the brig, I think, right?
I will have to drop it before you make the roll, but if you decide to nuke, I can help the die roll.
Either that or we need to challenge Dark on being a fucking Cylon.
Dark, come on. Make a call, man. Either way, we're really fucked, man. Like, even if you destroy that, we're still having to fight a lot.
Right, and the problem with this situation right here is the tie is it's clockwise. So even if we lose everything here, they kill these two ships, they go to this one and kill that one. They go to this one and kill that one. Like, this is a problem that we have to focus the Vipers on. We don't have the luxury. Oh yeah, I guess the Galactica guns can also.
Galactica with the weapons control.
But you're thinking that they're going to get an attack next time in the final.
Well, you can.
Check your cards and see if there's an action to nuke a bunch of shit or like to kill things or something. I don't know. Like.
Well, I'm thinking. I'm that the there. What happens if a Viper is killed?
Get me out of the goddamn brig.
Say that again?
What happens if a Viper is killed when it's piloted?
It is removed from the game and the pilot goes to sickbay.
Fire the nuke.
If you're going to use a nuke, let me know.
See, Dark, as I view it, we need to get these Vipers right here to here. Well, at least one of them to here. To soak the damage so that these don't move away, and so that we can continue to whittle these down. These are going to be here for a while. We need to remove this threat from the game as quickly as possible, and then we also have to be concerned about the heavy raider.
Listen,
but that's kind of a bit.
Is either nuking that shit or
Bruce, you beautiful bastard. Thank you so much.
Away from jumping away.
Thank you for the biddy spam.
There's that. You're not gonna go away. This is not gonna go away magically like we have so far.
How are you, Brucey?
It's gonna stay there.
Dark Iron.
The Cylon.
I'm sorry if I start to make sense, but you just have to listen to me. It's true. Either you nuked that shit,
said the Cylon,
or you're not jumping away from that. Okay, let's make that clear. Jumping away from.
Well, we have at least three turns of good, like relatively good, crisis cards to even get to the point of leaving with losing a bunch of shit. So.
Well, you're gonna get away limping. That's one choice. That's true. Maybe you won't even lose a single civilian ship, but the nuke is a preemptive solution.
I just feel like it's a good. I think it's.
It's good, but I wouldn't use it here. For instance, I wouldn't use it in the where there's the four fighters and the base star. I would use it to kill the heavy raider. I don't know if the nuke.
Right,
you can't kill the best.
You can't. Yeah.
Base star and three raiders.
What better situation are we gonna have to use the nukes than two attacks at the same time?
I wonder the same. I don't think it's gonna get any better than that.
Worst admiral ever.
I like the little
right. Dark. Adama would 100% use a fucking nuke right here. Start role playing.
What you're talking about, this base there at the back is not actually a threat.
No, this is not. You'd use it here, because
this base there here is kind of a threat. Okay, fair enough. But he's only really attracted two Vipers and one civilian ship.
Okay, think of it like this, Dark. If this, if
these two civilian ships here are going to be fucked no matter what happens, because they're going to kill these two, and then they're going to kill these two. So there's no way we're nuking our way out of this pip.
Well, you can't nuke.
But you can nuke your way out this pip, move these two fighters forward.
That bit is not the biggest threat at the moment. The bit here is losing two civilian ships. So the best thing to do would be to move the communications and move these two ships away from this area and to suck up the possible loss of the two Vipers.
That's true. Actually, that makes a lot of fucking sense. I mean,
it's like you can't nuke these guys away, so we're going to lose these two, which could be fucking catastrophic. We might lose this if these guys roll well and they actually get a shot.
Okay, well, can I say something here? Is
I support that shit. I support your calm move.
So, if we do not deal with this Baystar and these raiders, then and we pull the heavy raider, it's going to advance, and they pull the heavy raider again, it's going to board. No matter what happens, as long as these are here.
Even though it boards, it's not game over. All that happens when they board is one of these guys goes on the boarding party track, and they have to get heavy raiders activate, heavy raiders activate, heavy raiders activate, and then we lose. So
okay.
That's not the end of the world if it boards up.
Okay. All right, that's fine.
Yeah, I think that's a very sound. I haven't thought about it, and it's great. If you move those two out of the way, you're right. We're probably going to lose those Vipers. But other than
what happens, just out of curiosity, what happens if these first two, like if the Raiders activate, these first two kill these two Vipers? Do these then go here?
No.
They would go here, because a tie goes counterclockwise.
And they go clockwise.
Sorry. And then we have no defenses on, but... It's just this is a fucking mess.
It's a fantastic mess, man. It's a great ethical dilemma as well. But it's fantastic. The Admiral nailed the problem. I think it's the best thing to do is to move those two ships above.
Shut up, Cylon.
I think it's the best on plan. He's not burning one of your two most tactical assets, the nuke, and he's getting ships out of the way.
You don't have to move it if you...
Or can I just check one other one and then move it?
You have... If you checked it, you have to either move it or leave it.
So if you want to leave it as a meat shield because it's useless, then leave it.
But if it's not a meat shield, we're going to know very quickly. Just saying.
And then the Cylon.
Alright, boys. Happy talks about
the cruises. Did we do? What?
Let's see what
you got. Well, he didn't. He looked at it, but he chose not to move this one.
Oh.
He's using it as a meat shield.
All right. Oh,
what the ever loving fuck?
That's not even possible.
Well, so these don't. Yeah. Nothing happens here. Right. We just go to the activate. Okay. Well, we're going to find out real quick what's going on here. What's that?
We activate this, and then we get more civilian ships in it. No,
yeah,
these don't activate yet. This isn't...
You would get another Viper out?
Well, no. The first thing we do is activate Raiders. So we have to resolve all of...
That doesn't go out yet.
We have to resolve all of these die rolls. So this is Dark's roll. We're going to start in this box, okay?
This is insane. Just like...
It is insane.
There's another one after this. There's only like five total.
That is really unlucky.
Four in a row.
Well, this is how we lose the game. Okay, Dark, start your roll. I will count off the Raiders. That's a three? Is that a three? Nothing happens. Roll again. That's a six. Viper is damaged.
How do we choose between Vipers and the civilian ship?
We get to choose. Civilian ship goes at the end, always.
Yeah, no, they will always attack. Yeah, the Vipers are dogfighting them. Five.
Oh,
Vipers damaged.
No, that's an eight.
Wait.
That's an eight?
That's an eight.
It rolled. Okay.
Reroll.
Reroll
it and subtract two. He doesn't want to die.
Well, this is me.
Oh awesome. My god.
Damaged.
Well, at least you're damaged, but just
no,
this.
And that's me. That's me. Sick.
Is it?
I'm up front.
Oh.
Yeah.
My bad. Okay. So Bell goes to sick bay. Did we move the third raider?
It doesn't.
So these are right.
The rest of the raiders are just gonna destroy the next.
Right, but. Right, but this is. Well, no, we still roll, right? We still.
There's no roll.
Automatically destroyed. No roll. Okay, so this guy is here, and this guy flipped is a meat shield. So, and now these four activate to here.
And move there, yeah.
Okay, now we are doing these four. We are rolling these four right here. So dark roll. One, nothing happens.
Nothing.
Second roll. What's happening? Play before any die roll to add.
You're adding.
Yeah, you wanna. Cylon!
Don't say before any roll, okay? Be careful, because it says add.
Okay. Oops. This roll.
Roll number two.
Fucking Cylon.
Six.
So damaged Viper. Oh, we're gonna be fucking out of Vipers here. Third roll. Two, nothing happens. Fourth raider.
Six, yep. Damaged Viper.
And I go to med bay. I'm fairly sure this is the end of the game, somehow. I don't know what actually happens, but...
No, we're okay. We already got damaged, so...
Okay, so this civilian ship does not die yet. Right?
Because
there's no activation of Raider or Base Star.
Exactly. And the special rule says, well, the two Base Stars have already been placed down. The Vapor is now placed down.
Okay, so, but we still, I think we still need to activate each Base Star immediately attacks.
But it's a setup, so we need to move the Base.
The Base Stars are moved?
I don't think the setup
okay.
Moves.
So I think the Base Stars are moved. And you play three more civilian ships. I already placed the Viper.
Did we decide we move the... I don't think we move the Base Stars. Because those would be deployed Base Stars. Like, you deploy these two Base Stars.
If there were more, then we put more in there. But since we can't, the ones we have stay.
This is so fucking bad.
There's one more civilian ship in here that should be. There's only one. Should be only one.
Right, but there was one... Oh, was...
One already.
No, look at the cards. There's only one there. You look at all the cards, only one goes there.
Yeah, but we
in the back.
Yeah, but not.
Yeah.
We really need to jump away, guys. Fucking
okay.
Right now.
We can't even. We haven't even advanced anything.
Fucking shit. Who's next?
I am. Yeah. Is this? Have we completed?
No, they still need to attack Galactica.
Oh, right, yeah, the Base Stars need to attack Galactica.
But they activate it? The Base Stars activate?
I still think, yeah, so it doesn't say...
Yeah, each Base Star, yeah.
It says each Base Star, not deployed Base Stars. So each Base Star immediately attacks Galactica. How do the Base Stars attack? With Base Star, 4-8 damage. Okay, so Dark rolls again, 4-8. Or anything less than 4. So 5. Does anybody have anything to modify this? Does anybody have anything to modify this?
To result, no. No, I can only add stuff. I cannot deduct stuff.
Okay. So we flip a damage token, yeah?
Yep.
Galactica, what
damage,
is that? Just
right?
Damage?
Just Galactica damage?
Yeah.
Isn't there like a...
How much damage can Galactica take?
Isn't there like a damage meter thing?
Doesn't look like there's a damage track. Well, let's just place it here on top of a Galactica and keep track of that, because there are cards...
Well, there's like an in-game damage to Galactica thing that we should probably figure out here.
I remember it was 8. 8 tokens. I think 8 tokens means that Galactica's dead.
Alright, so one more roll, right?
Yeah.
Yep, one more roll.
Hopefully it's three or less. No, that's another damage to Galactica.
Damage token, and this is, what is that, Hangar Bay? Jesus fuck.
We cannot launch any more fighters until that damage repaired. Not that we have money.
I really feel like this game is over, boys.
Wow, yeah.
Okay.
That's absolutely catastrophic.
So this completes, oh, Jesus fuck. This completes this.
But you can go on with your turn, Moby.
Six or more damage to Galactica is a loss.
Oh, six only. So that means we're
is there any specification for generic damage tokens?
It just counts as one.
Okay, so it doesn't have to be applied to a random space, like a random tile or whatever.
Right. So okay.
So this is just two damage, with the hangar bay being hangar deck being out of commission.
Yes. Okay.